We outside Westminster today. This building behind me. Decisions have been made in this building which have caused the deaths of more people on this planet than anywhere else. The total death toll of the British Empire is a staggering 2 billion people. It's more disgusting than all the people that died in the First World War, of all the people that died in the Second World War. They set out to take over as many countries in the world as they could, and they caused death and destruction everywhere they went. It's disgusting. We have got to put an end to war, and war criminals like Tony Blair, who is responsible for the deaths of over 1.5 million Iraqis, and also responsible for the British servicemen that were sent into an illegal war and came back in a box. Let me tell you about war. In the First World War, there were 37 million casualties. So it was decided that the countries of the world would get round the table and sign a renunciation of war. It was called the Kelch-Briand Pact. They all signed the document. They all signed a renunciation of war. It was even signed by the CEO of the United States of America. And all the other countries signed and took part in it, said they would never go to war again. The war to put an end to all wars. The First World War. 37 million casualties. But what happened? We went on to have another war. The Second World War. There were 65 million casualties. It's disgusting. They signed a document, the renunciation of war, international war law. They don't even believe their own laws. They think they're above the law. Doesn't matter whether it's here or whether it's America. They don't obey international war law that they signed up to. Look at our people, the Kelch-Briand Pact. It is international war law, the renunciation of war. There shouldn't be any wars. Did you see in the news the other day that wee boy with a bow covered in rubble? He was one of the lucky ones. Some of these wee children are brought out in bits and pieces. It's disgusting. We have got to get rid of these people in this building. We continue on the warmongering course. They're spending all the money in wars. All you people could be better off. They're spending all the money in bloody wars. And the destruction that they rain on this planet must come to an end. We're going to do our best to make sure that Tony Blair is brought to justice. We have already had dozens of people go into police stations and report Tony Blair as a war criminal. The more people that we get to go to police stations and report Tony Blair and other war criminals, the more chance we have of getting them brought to justice. If you need any help, come forward. I'll tell you what to do. Get this guy done. Get him in the Hague in Holland and done for war crimes. He is responsible for the deaths of over 1.5 million Iraqis. Thank you. This is the Scottish resistance. We will never give up the fight for Scotland's freedom. They rigged the referendum in Scotland. Believe me, they did it. They made it. Sure, it was 45%. It relates to the 1735 rebellion. 45%. 5%. And there will be two polls in Scotland, the Yes can't win. But they rigged it because they need the oil revenue. Scotland is the richest country in Europe in terms of oil. Every country that has oil has been invaded, whether it be Iraq, Libya, you name it. They have been invaded and taken over because of oil revenue. Now, when the Soviet Union broke up, lots of little republics were given their freedom, apart from one, Chechnya. The reason is that Chechnya is very, very rich in oil. They would not let Chechnya go. So all of a sudden, these Chechens have labeled as terrorists and separatists just because they wanted freedom, like all the other wee states within the former Soviet Union. It's all about oil, folks. That's what all these wars are about. They've got to put an end to these wars. Get people like Tony Blair put in trial in a Hague. He is a war criminal. And we have got to get something done about getting this guy behind bars. Thank you.